Photopea is the best free Photoshop alternative that I've tried, and it's web-based, so you don't even need to download anything. I normally use Photoshop, but I've been trying this out over the past couple of weeks because people often say they don't have the software and think it excludes them from print-on-demand. It definitely doesn't, so don't worry about that. I'll talk you through how it works so you can start making money, or even use it for other purposes. As you can see from the default page here, you've got the option to start a new project. And when we click this, you'll be presented with all these templates. Many of them are actually quite nice, but we won't be using that for t-shirt design. They also have shortcuts down here on the left where you can select what type of project you're doing and it'll choose the pixels automatically for you. If you're making designs for t-shirts, you'll want to specify 4,500 pixels by 5,400 pixels and a transparent background. But just before I do that, I'll show you what else you can do on the homepage. You can open files from your computer. I've frequently given Photoshop templates in my videos which have PSD extensions, and I've noticed people commenting saying that they're not able to access them. Photopea can open PSD files as well as XD, Sketch, PDF, XCF, RAW, and other file types. That means you can open the t-shirt design template from Merch by Amazon or the t-shirt mockup that I showed in my previous video. Alternatively, you can use their free templates if you're doing other editing work, and they've got some demo files at the bottom here so you can get to grips with using the software. Milk.sketch, for example, which looks like this, and has all the different layers that you can see down here on the right-hand side. So the software's quite powerful despite it being web-based. And we've got p.psd. Again, this shows the functionality because it has Photoshop-style effects like stroke and gradient. Stroke is this outline around the P that you can turn on and off in the layers menu here by clicking the I button. Same goes for gradient. You can also edit these by double-clicking on them just like you can do in Photoshop. The shadow underneath is also a separate layer that you can move around. These are the same things that Photoshop has, so you can add a drop shadow under the effects menu and everything else that's listed here too. So let's look at the common features used for t-shirt designs. I'll create a new canvas just like I would do in Photoshop by going to File, New. Most people, when they're just starting out, tend to stick to text-based designs because they don't have the skills to do anything beyond that. And that's fine, it's not a problem at all. I've made thousands of dollars from text-based designs, and if you look at some of the top sellers on Redbubble and Merch by Amazon right now, you'll see text-based designs making a lot of money. In order to add text, you just need to click the T down here on the left. You can see from the menu options at the top that it's changed, so you have access to the font, attributes, size, colour, justification, and other stuff too. You don't need to worry about that right now, because you can change it all after you've typed something. I've just typed test. But as you can see, or rather not see, the text is tiny because it's size 42 by default and we've got a massive canvas ready for print. So I'm going to make this font bigger by moving the size at the top. The slider here only goes up to 150, but we can manually type a number in if we want to go higher. Or, an even better trick if you want to resize the font without guessing the size number that'll be appropriate, just click on the Move tool at the top, which will allow you to transform your text into something larger by dragging it at the corners. You might have messed up the aspect ratio by doing that, which is no problem, because you can click this button up here, these lines, to make sure that the aspect ratio is maintained. When you click back on the T down here at the left, you'll get access to the size information again, and you can see up here at the top that the font's changed as well. The same applies to images, so you can keep the aspect ratio by using the same process. Click the Move tool, then drag to where you want it to be, and click Keep Aspect Ratio. Now let's make a t-shirt design. I'm just going to put the text here, which will be a wordplay joke. Let's eat kids. Let's eat kids. Punctuation saves lives. Now it's there, I can change all sorts by using the options at the top. You've got access to a wide range of fonts anyway, as well as this search tool, and amazingly the option to add your own fonts in as well. So you can literally go on Google and put free fonts, and you'll find websites like 1001 Free Fonts, Dafont, Font Squirrel. So if you're going for a particular style, you can have a look on here and upload it to Photopea to use in your design. I like Dafont because you can organise by those fonts that are free for commercial use, which means you can make money from them without worrying about getting copyright claims. When you click a category, you can filter here at the top. So you click More Options and then 100% Free. You can even type your text in here to see if it looks good with your desired font. Then, when you're happy, you can download it to use in Photopea. When you add it, You can ask Photopea to save it so it will be there when you next open it. Super easy. Okay, now the font's there. I'm just going to center it by moving the text with the Move tool until I see the red lines appear, which lets me know it's central on the canvas. You can change the colour of the font by selecting the text and clicking up here at the top, which opens the colour picker, and then you can choose whatever you like. I'm going to keep mine black for now so it's easy to see. You can also go to Layer and then Layer Style to find some of the cool options like Stroke and Shadow that I mentioned before. If you wanted, you can also warp the text by clicking Warp up here and changing the options. I don't want it warped, so I'm going to get rid of that. At this point, I could just leave the design as it is, just as text, save it and upload it to a print-on-demand website. But I'm going to find an image that's free to use for commercial purposes. So again, I can literally just type commercial use images into Google and be presented with a list of size that are appropriate. Pixabay will do for now. So I'm looking for a dinosaur and specifically one with a transparent background. So I don't have to do any extra work on the design. I can just put it straight on and it'll be fine to use. I'm going to use this image. I can just save it from the website because it's free to use for commercial purposes. So I go back to Photopea and I want to open and place it. If you click open, it will open in a new canvas and you'll have to move it across. So let's skip the middleman and just open and place. Now I'm going to merge all these together to see what it looks like on a shirt. I'm going to copy this whole canvas, open my mockup template and paste the design on here to see what it looks like. There we go, finished. At this point, you're probably thinking, this design sucks and nobody would buy it, right? Well, let me end this video with a bang because here it is on Amazon with a sales rank of 5,757. BSR means bestseller rank. And a rank this low means it's selling around 450 shares a month. Since it's priced at $16.99, there's a profit margin for the person who made it of about $2.96 per sale. 450 times 296 means the person's making around $1,300 a month from this one shirt alone. Imagine what you'd do with an extra $1,300 per month. What I've shown you today is just the tip of the iceberg in terms of Photopea. You can do very complicated things with this website and there's an excellent help section that you can use to learn everything you need to know bit by bit. You'll improve with each new design that you create and hopefully you'll start making a lot of money too as you begin to understand what the market wants. If you're interested in learning more about print on demand, then subscribe to this channel because I release new content every week which is designed to help you make sales. I've already got a load of videos on my channel if you want to look back and I tell you everything you need to know for free.